This ain't nothing for the pack. Got 16 sitting in the lack. Whole squad all dressing all black. Every single last one of them got my back. Hey, 20 of us, that's 20 goons. And a ice cream whip, triple scoop. I got 3 strikes, ain't got to lose. When it's all on the line, what you gonna do? Come on, I'm highly favored. Don't wanna play me, no conversation, ain't got time for no.
And we come to you from one of the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL as you get a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Green Bay Packers. The final playoff push is upon us. It's week 12 of the NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports.
Here we go, here we go.
Complete to the former Aggie Jay Sternberger. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards on the game's opening play and a quick first down. One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. Oh, refusing to go down. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Packer first down. Well, no slow start here. A couple nice chunk plays back to back.
I love the momentum that they're showing here early because they did it both ways, right? Threw the ball on first down for a nice chunk of yardage. Came right back and ran the ball. Looks like they've got the defense set back on their heels. Let's see if they can keep this moving.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. He doesn't find a ton of space following the display of quick feet down just inside the 45. Ha-ha Clinton Dix, of course, a former Green Bay Packer there on the stop. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Here's Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 31-yard line. Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number 3 man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to 2nd down. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12.
10-30.
It's caught by Geronimo Allison. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a 3rd down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Keep it up, defense. Keep it up, guys.
Jeff, Jeff.
It comes to me, it's me. Don't hit the mic.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line.
Let's go.
Officially a gain of just 1 yard there, but they do convert on 3rd and inches.
I can't believe they let you play. I can't believe they even let you play.
Plant.
Motion, 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 motion.
Mike,
38.
Jones. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. It was Taven Bryan who got him down defensively.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20-point score, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. A.J. Boyer with a pick, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. Remember, of course, he threw 5 interceptions in that loss last week. Opening drive, same result here.
But it's hard to believe that you can throw 5 in the previous week and start out your very next game the exact same way. He's going to need a lot of support on his own sideline. Make sure he gets really fully, mentally into this one.
On the set.
Mike, 56, right there, 56.
Any weapons? Hey, Charlie!
56, Mike!
X3, 218, chopper!
Check! Watch the safety creep!
Now a handoff here to his running back. Space to maneuver at the 40. And finally, down at the 41-yard line. That one a pickup of 15 for Jacksonville.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. The tackle made by Blake Martinez.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Go!
Here we go, D, get off the field. Switch.
Rock it.
Minshew throwing on third down. Oh, he almost picked it. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. And that's a throw he'd like to have back. Now fourth down.
And third down is a key down in any game you play. And third down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the 5. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
They decided to take a shot and right down the middle of the field. And really, they didn't give it as much time to develop, did they? They want to take that shot somewhere around the 15-yard mark.
And the defense, able to recover, bat it free. To throw on second and 10. Rodgers, man open. That's Marquez Valdez-Scantler. The 40. He's at the 30. 10. Touchdown, Packers. Marquez Valdez-Scantling, 94 yards, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. So from back deep in their home territory all the way into the end zone. Do you think they expected to score on that one?
I'm not sure they expected to score, but they also showed that they're not averse to taking a little bit of a risk there, right? Taking a chance, because the normal call is take care of the football, run it, be safe. Instead, they put it in the air and took a gamble, and it paid off in a big way. That wasn't an analytics call. That wasn't a fantasy guy's call. That was like a video game call right there.
It was a little bit of a video game call, but it worked.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division. Looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs, so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for everyone possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Kevin King there defensively.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. From the gun, Minshew to throw. He's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. 25 yards that time.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop him?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
A bit of an opening there on the first down run as they get this forward for about 6 yards. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
From the 45 on second down, Minshew. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
You got to give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman, because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give him some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun is Minshew. Open man is Westbrook. Complete. His first catch. Good for nine and a first down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. This play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. Minshew sets to throw. And connecting here with DJ Shark. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. And Lambeau, he missed it. He missed it left. No good. And this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now Rodgers. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 35. And he may want to track down that football, because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Trying to get it there to D.D. Westbrook, but it's going to be second down. Here's second and 10 now from the 35.
Wahoo!
56,
come!
56, check 56.
Five.
On second and 10, it's Minshew. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. Looking to throw it, Minshew. And he completes it to Westbrook. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. D.D. Westbrook, his fourth touchdown on the year, as they are now on the board here in the first half.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown. So 7-7 to score. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. A.J. Boye with a pick. And a super return as he gets this all the way down inside the 25-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Minshew, first and 10. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
I would say it'd probably be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half, because they're definitely on different wavelengths. But I also don't advocate waiting that long next series before you get out there. Hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
Check, 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 check. Hey, two jet bombers, two jet bombers. Bang, 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 bang.
Then he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. Let him go by a little too easily there.
Well, that's what we saw in film, isn't it? His head goes down oftentimes when he goes to punch, when he's trying to block. And when you do that, you can't see your target. He went right past him and made the play.
Now Minshew, he's going to go up top for the end zone, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing, and on that one, they had the fly to send the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it. What people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
Hey, take 26.
They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he'll push forward for about four up to the 23.
Well, they did throw interceptions on their last two drives, so no surprise at all they decided to start it with a running play. I'm actually a little bit surprised, though, that they got as much out of it as they did.
Yeah, decent little gain. Puts them in a pretty good spot for second down. first carry now for the BYU man. It's Jamal Williams. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 15 there, and the Packers have a first.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Rodgers now on first down. And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. And the throw didn't give him a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up second down. They work again from the 38 on second and 10.
Motion man, watch 12.
Throwing again, Rodgers. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the linebacker, Miles Jack. And they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great effort there with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. They trail by 10, 17-7 as they come up on a first and 10. Here's a good way to kick off a drive, complete over the middle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, 22. They'll run on first down. It's Jones. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line, tackled there. 13 yards, first down Packers.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
And that's complete to Adams. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Got an open man, it's Valdez-Scantling. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Another nice gain, that's now 30 yards between those last two plays. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Here's Rodgers to throw. He sets up the screen to Jones. No gain on the screen there. It's second down. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime.
Two times.
Box it.
Looking to throw again on second down. Rodgers looking in zone, but it's incomplete. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver. But now it's third and goal.
I hate to sound really negative, but at this point, an incomplete pass, almost a moral victory that it's not picked off.
Well, you may hate to sound negative, but that was negative.
It was very negative.
And he's going to go down. Sacked right around the 17. Yannick Ngakoue in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. And the 14-year trusty veteran able to knock it through. And they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10.
So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line.
On the ready.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something they feel is somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12.
Here we go.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Jaguars in possession of the lead, and they will get the football as we are underway in the second half. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Let's go.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust your
touchdown, Jaguars. A great play there. His second touchdown of the game and his ninth on the year. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, being on second half, no matter what, with his first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
From the 31, Rodgers complete to Jones. He lost four there, and it's third down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side before lost yarded.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
Throwing now is Rodgers. Now look out, Rodgers lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets it.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
And to give this time to the tailback. And from the 15, they're able to work this up to the 20 for a pickup of a handful.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. So third and long, here's Minshew. The open man is Westbrook. It's a pickup of 13, but they're still a bit short, and it'll be fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. That'll be a 49-yard punt, 6 yards there on the return. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Rodgers now 10 of 17 throwing the ball. He's got a first and 10. A full five-yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough. On second down, it's Jones. He'll take this up just shy of the 40. Excellent display of footwork on that run.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
You better be ready. Don't be scared.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. He's got, and that's caught inside the 30. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. What a game it's been for this duo.
They remind me of a good comedy team. They know how to play off of each other so well. No matter how one riffs, the other's right there to pick them up, and they are shredding them in this ballgame.
This one to the right, caught by Valdez-Scantling. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
It's second and 8 at the 26-yard line.
You draw Porter.
Now a draw play. This is Jones. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
It's now third and 9.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Hey, take 26.
44 to Mike.
We are going.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. He's got the tight end, Sternberger. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Now Jones, he pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done, well, guess what? We see the end result. Right now, they have their eye on victory.
And leading here in the fourth.
A gain of 3 yards. It's now third and goal.
They've been so good on third down all day long. Can they convert another here on third and goal?
Both sevens of Mike. Both sevens of Mike.
It's coming this way. Coming this way. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Shit. 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 Switch.
They'll try and run it in with Jones. No gain on the play that time. So a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a fourth and goal.
I know this is your spot, partner, so forgive me for jumping in, but there's no decision right here. They have to go for it in this situation. They're down on the scoreboard. How many other opportunities are you going to get?
Yeah, I'm with you. Fourth quarter, like you said, down on the scoreboard. And remember here, a field goal virtually does them no good. The field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the six here on fourth and goal. Rodgers going to go on fourth down. And it's caught. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Jaguars are able to come up with a goal line stand. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now, really hoping for a turnover. Give them a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. The last run got a couple here. Second and eight. From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down.
What has not been the best game for him, but he definitely tried to get by with a little help from his friend there, trying to create a big play.
Couldn't do it, fell incomplete, but you're right, hasn't been a banner game here in the second half, just trying to get going.
Big thing is trying to keep confidence up and continue to fire.
They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off at the 16. So they take over not only in enemy territory, but in the red zone at the 16-yard line. So after the INT, it's Rodgers. And he's got it. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones with touchdown number 7 on the year. As his guys are back within a single score. Gostkowski with the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Throwing on second down now, Minshew. There he goes left side. And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys who are picking it off, they're not saying that. What word are they using? It's Oski. And that means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say Oski.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
A very important extra point there, up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown. This offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
I like that because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle. You know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there, it's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. See if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here.
I got you, Pop.
Again, it's Fournette. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
Minshew throwing on third down. A throw left side, complete to his receiver, Westbrook. That one a pickup of 15 for Jacksonville. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And that winds up a decent run, and it also takes us to the two-minute warning. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a score to break this tie. They'll run it now out of the gun. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down? They'll try to throw for it with Minshew. And this is going to be intercepted. Kevin King with a pick. 20, 10, and they will score. It's a Packer touchdown. In a tie game, fourth quarter, that's about as big of a defensive play as you can possibly make.
And it didn't happen by accident. That was scouting right there. They've seen things that have happened before. They knew in certain situations the type of plays they like to run. Read it, and were able to go after the football, get it, and take it into the end zone for a touchdown for themselves.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. Now on the return. Oh, no, the ball is loose.
When you kick off and you go downfield and get the ball back, that's what I call a great opportunity.
In a one-score game, I always circle, and you know this, but in my play-by-play sheet, I circle big plays. It could be turning points. This could be a turning point.
Did you put a second circle around this one? This
I put a star. I put a star. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. 11 yards there for Jacksonville, and a first down as well. Back to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 30. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him, let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front, good blocking, nice hole for him, ends up picking up nice yardage, stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They are in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
And not in any rush offensively. It's a pickup of 13, and with that 13 yards, this ball game just about over. It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. Comeback that we just witnessed going into the fourth quarter. I don't know that we had written them off, but it looked bleak. They were able to get it done.
They put up a barrage of points, and reeling them in and running them down and winning it. Wouldn't you love to be in their locker room right now? Think about the energy that's radiating out of there right now. They're talking about belief, sticking together, and finding a way to win.
So for the Packers, the win gets them a step closer to 500 at 5-6. And they'll get to stay home again next week. Meanwhile, for the Jaguars, it's a loss that sets them back in their playoff push as they fall to 6-5. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to Houston to take on the Texans. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
I'm ready like live. gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen.
Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Get ready, dog.
Rocket fuel.
Yeah, I just ran a check up on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These, I could get it by myself.